Reliance Commercial Finance presents India SME Forum 2012. Find out the secrets of success in a series of seminars exclusively for smart entrepreneurs. Join India's biggest SME initiative to boost your business and celebrate SME achievers with India SME 100 Award.
Firstly, a cool welcome to this event. Before we start on what I want to speak all about funding and debt and how do we raise debt, just let me go back to my childhood days. When I was small, anything south of Maharashtra was called Madrasis. Irrespective of whether you are a Tamilian, Telugu, anything, we were always taught anything south of Maharashtra is a Madrasi, anything north of Delhi is a Punjabi. That's how we used to normally, so irrespective of whatever language you speak. And outside Rajasthan, everybody is a Marwadi. Irrespective of again whether you come from Udaipur, Jodhpur, Jaipur, wherever you come from, outside Rajasthan, everybody represents only one community and people will call them Marwadi. That's the way you people are looked outside Rajasthan. I was again told in a childhood days, businessman of the year, I mean the business, who manages the businesses worldwide? Worldwide, Jews are the businessmen of the world. In India, it's the Marwadis. If you want to name any business, I mean successful businessman, it has to be somebody or the other, somewhere or the other is linked to Rajasthan. Maybe forefathers, which generation, we don't know. So in fact, when we were doing this forum, SME forum, we are going to do it across some 12, 14 cities. So when it came to Jaipur, I said no. Jaipur is something where I would like to go. That's the place where I would like to interact with people. These are the guys who understand business. These are the guys who have been doing business for age-old times. These are the people who have done business not only in Rajasthan, but this set of community you will find from, say, a Guwahati to a Dwarka, from Kanyakumari to a Kashmir. I mean, you go to any market. Recently, I was in Chennai market. I mean, I don't know how many of you have been visited Chennai, but the whole Chennai street market is managed by Maharashtra. Given that importance, okay, now let me come back to what is the importance of an SME for us, as an individual, for us as a country. SMEs put together put 45% of the Indian industrial production to the state. We contribute around about 17% of the GDP to the Indian, of the Indian economy. Anywhere between 40% of the exports are done by the SMEs and not by the big industry houses. SMEs as a whole employ 60 million people of this country. And that's why we are seeing that over a period of time there has been a shift from big industries to SMEs. Every banker, every financier, everybody we talk about is now talking about focusing on the SME. But these are the guys who are going to take us to that next level. I mean, I can go on giving you statistics worldwide also, what is the importance of SME, what is the importance of those middle guys in the whole spectrum of their own economy. I mean, you can name it. As US, 79% of the GDP of US is contributed by the middle people rather than the big G's and the General Motors of the world. We are also seeing over the last 10 years the kind of importance which we are giving to these people, the people which they are bringing on table. And so therefore this whole logic of doing a forum around SMEs and not a forum around a large corporates. I mean, large corporates, they have, I mean, you can always do with them, but these are the people who are going to take us to that next level. Fair enough, that's what SMEs are all about. Now coming back to funding SMEs, how do you people can raise money? I mean, The best part about this audience is, I mean, they know people in this country understands money better than you people. I mean, talking about money to this set of people, I mean, it would be a big challenge for any speaker saying how do you understand money, but still let me give a shot at it. And how as we financiers look at this conference? I mean, I want to dwell more upon that piece of what do we look into you rather than what you look into us. The first factor, I will not dwell upon too much on the financial parameters. You people understand finance like nobody else. But still, nonetheless, let me put 2 minutes on the financials. That okay, fair enough. The financials needs to be growing, the ratios needs to be in the right place, your CDMA, your working capital, your all those needs to be in the right place so that a guy who is giving you money needs to have that comfort. So one thing which everybody needs to keep in mind when I am giving out money, or anybody is giving out money for that matter, what is he looking at? Only two things. Return of equity and return on equity. If I'm assured of these two stuff, here when I say equity, you can replace the word equity with the loan or with the funding, with whatever you want to. Once I'm assured of these two stuff, money is yours. I need to get my principal back in time, on time, and that interest portion with it back on that particular time. Once I'm assured of that, money is yours. Any financier, be it an NBFC, be it a bank, will have no issues in funding any individual till the time these two parameters are very, very clear back of my mind. How do I look at those parameters? So one, of course, would be your financial parameters that you see at the balance sheet of the company, the P&L, whether it is growing, whether these ratios are all fine, not fine. And you go through that and you arrive at the eligibility and all those stuff of the individual. But more so important now in this current environment, more than the financial parameters, is the non-financial parameters which play a bigger role, bigger weightage than the financial parameters. Financial parameters we all understand. For all those commerce students we have studied from the standard level. How do we look at those numbers? But today's date, what is more important is the non-financial parameters which one looks into it. Be it me, be it Mr. Harvinder, he also looks at who is the promoter behind the company. What is the product? Is it a growing product? What is the kind of structure in which the organization works? Is it an individual-led company? Is it a family-led company? Is it a group of people-led company? Who are the people behind that organization? That plays a big role in deciding, maybe it's debt, maybe it is equity, maybe it's anything. It plays a very big role on the kind of background of that individual who are running that business, who are running that SME. What kind of background he has, what kind of knowledge he has, what kind of education he has, what is his experience in that business. So that plays a very important role. What is his vision for the company? Where he wants, do you want to be there? Or do you want to, how fast you want to grow? All those makes a very important parameter when you go out to look for any kind of financier. Be it equity, debt, on the liability side, whenever you are looking for money, this will play a very, very important role in getting you that kind of money. The second important piece which comes in is the business model itself. Sustainable, growable, are you in the sunrise industry, sunset industry, what kind of industry you are in, what is the technology you are in, is your technology something which is up to date, is your technology which can become obsolete tomorrow. I mean, just to give you an example, maybe a decade back, a lathe machine was the in thing. But today's date, if you try to put a lathe machine, I don't think anybody will give you a single penny to lend. Till about a decade or two decades back, manufacturing shirts through a mechanism. I mean, we all saw people used to keep tailors and get it manufactured. Today's date, that's an obsolete technology. You need to have the latest machines to manufacture, including ready-mades. So what kind of technology are you using? What is the prospects in your industry? All those will also play a role in getting you to that number. It's not sheer financials which will get you those numbers. So that also plays a very big role into the kind how you get your money. Third important stuff in today's world, which is very, very important, where we as financiers or the whole financial community look at is where you are getting your money. You'll ask me, I mean, what's so big about it? But we've seen examples, we've seen n number of examples of money taken in for a purpose A, and ultimately the end use goes somewhere else. People borrow on the balance sheet and buy land. People borrow on balance sheet and invest in, say, a building, saying real estate is going to give me big returns and let me leverage my balance sheet. Your end use of my funds becomes a very, very important parameter for us saying where is my money going to get used, how it is going to get used. But that will decide my ability and capability to pay it back. I don't know the property, land which you are buying, will it appreciate tomorrow? Will it appreciate tomorrow? Will it have a market tomorrow? When you need, will you be able to really resell it? Whenever in doubt, I don't go out. So that is also a very big point which one needs to keep in mind, and one needs to have a confidence between the borrower and the lender when it comes to borrowing money. Third important stuff, I mean the next important point is, are you in an innovative industry? Is there a lot of innovation in the way you work? And how could I show it to the world that I am a guy who has done innovations? Do you have awards for any technology? Are you recognized? Do you have any patents, trademarks for your process, for your product? It helps us. Saying yes, there is this set of individuals, there is this set of people who are doing, trying to do something new, something different, and this is a benchmark for them. This is a proof saying yes, he has a couple of patents, he has two trademarks, he has process patent, blah, blah, blah. On those fronts. So one factor which I am not very sure how many people do really take care of that and who give importance to that is performance of your existing loans. How well are you performing on your existing loan? How does it impact? It impacts three sets of people. It affects you today, it affects you people tomorrow, and the biggest impact is it impacts your community. When I say community in the sense, not the social community which you belong to, but community as a market. Like I'll give you a simple example. Most of the financiers will not go to the Aurangabad market for doing auto finance. Historically, the background has been in Aurangabad market, I mean to put it in a very crude term, gadiya kat jati. There is a tendency in customers there, they just open up the car and sell off the car. So we as financiers will not touch Aurangabad market. Now you will come and tell me, everybody doesn't do that. Maybe 5 people out of 100 or 10 people out of 100 might be doing that. But the brand of that market is, if you go and land in Aurangabad market, there's a big probability that you might be one of them. So when you perform on your loan, it is not only you are helping yourself, but you are helping the whole community around yourself for tomorrow. Today's date, when we go and say that the Alwar belt for CV is a very good market. Why? All transporters in Alwar have a very good performance on prepayment. There you might have an odd one out who might not be paying on time. But I am doing a generic stuff that Alwar is a good market to lend for commercial vehicles. So same thing applies, that when you pay on time or you don't pay on time, it is not only you who get impacted, but these people around you who also get impacted. Lastly, what do we look at? Or what should you look from your financier? I mean, everybody nowadays would be knowing the concept of KYC. Know your customer. So you have a certain set of documents which you will give, your passport copy or your ration card or something, PAN card, address proof, identity proof, which will prove that yes, this is Mr. Sanjay Parekh, he stays in XYZ place, proof. But we say no, that's knowing KYC is a past. Today's date, terminology which is coming up, it has to be a UIC. Understand your customer. I need to understand my customer so that I can create an environment of relationship with those people. And therefore, what do we do? And therefore, the next stage comes in is for every institution, be it a bank, wherein we come up with something called as key account management, where most of the organizations will run something called a key account management, where key account, these are the key customers, where our people will be in touch with all the customers, key customers, all the time to understand that, rather than know that. There's no point in knowing Mr. Vivek. But it is more important to understand him. What is he? Where is he? Where is he going? And at what stage can I walk with him all the way? It's not a question of just giving one loan, taking it back. No, that is not the intention in today's finance world. I need to walk with you people all the time, every time. And therefore, we put more importance on the performance part of it. If you have a stress, come back to the financier. Tell him this is an issue. I'm very sure when you two sit together, there will be a solution. Rather than shying away from the financier. Today's day, what we've seen experiences, generally people, if they have a problem, first thing is they try to avoid the financier. No point in doing that. I mean, you will all be aware in today's world of civils of the world and all, your data is known to everybody. Your performance of your loans are known to everybody in the industry. It's better to sit with the financier, understand with them, and then manage your whole overall environment in which you are working. Today's date, so therefore, as you need, if I am going a step further in trying to understand you, you also need to understand us. Okay. Any point of time, I'm not talking of Reliance as an entity, I'm talking of representing the whole financial market, the financiers as a whole. And we both need to walk together rather than you walking in one direction and taking, we are not those age-old money lenders, age-old dadas who were lending money. I still remember my grandfather telling me, I don't know, people who understand Gujarati or understand Hindi, the way the maths used to work when you were recovering interest from those poor peasants or from whoever you have lent. I mean, just to give an example, in Gujarati, the max used to be 70 pancha panchano. 17 paisa 95. De mukya chhutna. 2 rupiah diya discount. Lao patel swame doka. That was the way money lenders and the customers were treated maybe say 30 years back or 50 years back. Today's date, that is not the status. Today's date, we both walk together, talk together, we live together so that you grow. And I do. Yet, at any point of time, it is not that I as a financier want to take everything from you and make myself, no, it doesn't work that way. I can make one person take it around more from him once, but not always. And this is a business which I am there for always. So that's a small thing, the way we, I want to, I mean, I was told that we need to speak on financial parameters, and this is not the audience where I need to talk on financial parameters. This audience understands finance much more than most of us understand. So this is not the place where I can talk about current ratios and debt equities of the ratios of the world, no. And I don't want to talk about all this in this forum. The only thing which I want to put across you people, everybody, is that do not take your financier as somebody who is there to please you. We are here to walk with you, talk with you, and let's grow together. Neither I can grow alone nor you can grow alone. We have to grow together. So that's the way I look at financial performances. That's the way I look at fund. When I look at my customers, that's the way I look at you people. And our simple request from the finance community, you also need to look at us in the same manner. It's at any point of time, neither am I competing with my other guy. Yes, fair enough. Rates 25 bps here, there, 50 bps here, there will always be there. But you need to understand your financier and hope your financier has understood you. If both is there, life is brilliant. So, I'll end here, sir. And maybe the questions part we can either take together. Sure. Or, if you have any questions right now, post this panel. Of course, through the gate, I'm available here. We can always discuss.